Let's watch another Clannad After Story episode. Last episode, so Nagisa and Tomoya trying to manage their everyday life together, but they couldn't find the time to spend time together because Nagisa has school and Tomoya has the job. And one thing to note from the Nagisa side, she lost the theater club. Well, clearly she couldn't keep it running because it's missing sufficient members and the advisor cannot really help her a lot. And then on Tomoya's side, so he's having some mistakes here and there. Again, he's a rookie, but Yoshino noticed that he has injury on his right shoulder. But it seems like it's implied that he's keeping a secret between the two of them. Because of that, I mean, also Tomoya's hard work, he now landed a full-time job in this work. So good for him. Yeah, simple story. Well, from that last episode, it's just basically some mundane adult stuff. A little bit of an obstacle here and there. But they seem to be managing themselves independently. So that's good. And let's see what's going to happen here. So, episode 12. 3, 2, 1, go. That's good. That's good. Looking good for him. Same with Nagisa. I really hope that father and son thing get resolved. It's him, isn't it? What crime? Wow, that's tough. Depression caught up to him. I guess, yeah, along the way he forgot. Here we go again. These two are cute, man. Ooh. Oh no. Oh, don't get mad at your dad. But what did he do? That is true. He's just taking it. I really wonder what happened to these two. Ooh. Seriously, a this point, we still don't know what happened in the past between Tomoya and his dad. Like, all we know is Tomoya's mom died when Tomoya is in his young age, when he was a kid. And growing up, he started hating his dad more and more. I guess his dad is just, he lost his loved one. So understandably that he's kind of like feeling like giving up in a way. But at the same time, it's bad because it's affecting the kid, which is in this case Tomoya. So I guess that's basically it, right? That's from the part of Tomoya why he's so mad at his dad. I'm assuming that may be. But if I look at Tomoya's dad's shoes, I feel like he wants to amend his relationship with his son. But I'm waiting for that conversation between the two, like some sort of resolution, you know? Like, the dad, at least speak up and say what's on your mind, say what you want to say to your son. I mean, I guess on season one, he did try to congratulate him for the theater club. He tried to, you know, say hi, but Tomoya is just being so standoffish. Like, he didn't even want to stay in the same room with his dad for too long. He really, really hates him. So that's why I'm thinking like it's probably more than being that he got ignored by his dad. And the fact that the dad is just taking it all, like all the bad mouth that Tomoya has been saying, all the anger, like he's just taking it all in, not saying anything. And he's just kind of like smiling whenever he meets Tomoya. I feel like he has this self-awareness that he knows that it's his fault that Tomoya is so angry at him. I wonder what crime that he did. Wow. And yeah, obviously Tomoya will like further get mad at him because he can't even progress to his job, to the position that he's been offered because of this. Tough. And Yoshino's story. Holy shit. Yeah, we've been told before that he was a singer. But I didn't know. Wow. What a story. What a life story. And good thing he found his happiness, right? Okay, well, let's see. I'm happy in a way that because these two are getting married or will get married. I guess that's one option for Nagisa to move forward, like to get out of high school. Jeez, what a story, what an episode. But that should be it for now. I'll see you guys next time. All right, see ya. Bye.